Hey guys, Kyle Spreedies here from Soul Gazing Photography. Thanks for joining me. I wanted to share with you something that's been quite difficult for me to photograph over the years, and it's been artworks. So drawings, paintings, you know, different things in that arena seem to get a lot of reflection when you use lighting. So what's really important and what I'm going to try and take you through in this video is light balance. So working out how to combine lighting and how to use lighting in terms of light balance. And now, one of the things I always say is that it's not just about lighting. It's not just about chucking a flash on the camera and, you know, splashing someone with a bunch of light and seeing how it comes out. It's about light modification. It's about how can you modify the light to make it look as natural as it can be, and also just add a little bit of punch or a little bit of lift or get the color correction right through the lighting. So that's very important for artists when they want to replicate the work. And one of the artists that I work with a lot, she wants me to be able to take the photograph and she's going to edit it further, you know, in Photoshop, in, you know, Adobe, you know, Illustrator, different sort of things like that. So she wants me to be able to make sure that it's sharp across the image, so the lens can't have issues in terms of sharp in one corner, not sharp in the other corner, which a lot of lenses, especially zoom lenses, can tend to have issues like that, especially when you're shooting wide open. So one of the things you have to first do is shoot pretty close, so 5.6 to f8 aperture, which basically means you're allowing more in depth of field, and it's basically getting to the sharper points of the lens. Now, the main elements that we need to worry about is how we are reflecting the light. So if I just shoot this artwork down here, just and I go bang with light onto it straight, it's going to reflect all over the place and it's going to come back into the sensor and it's not going to look very good. So that's where I have to try and work out, okay, how am I going to reflect it? And in this environment, we've got white roofs, and we've got a lot of white in this room, which actually helps out. So what I've done is I've put our main key light here that's going to bounce and it's going to wash across the image there. Then we've got another light in the corner over there, and then basically that's going to, you know, splash a bit more light in. And then over here we've just got another light here. And one of the things that I was considering when I was looking at lighting this, I was thinking that I might use a reflector, because it's always good to have a reflector. What you can do with the reflector is if you bring it down onto the artwork, you can kind of see how you can add a little bit of light into the image, and that can also bounce. So if we've got too much light coming from this side, you know, that light can reflect, hit the reflector and wash over. But also the reflector might be a bit too, might cause a bit too much sheen. Now, what's the main purpose you, or one of the main things you want to capture, you know, when doing a drawing? What's one of the main elements that makes drawing so beautiful and art so beautiful? It's the gradients of light, dark and shadow. So you can see right here, there's a lot of dark, you know, and it goes to light, but this artist is really good at making those gradient differences, so you can see the different, you know, different graduations of light. And that's what actually makes contrast and makes the image really pop out. You don't want it too contrasty. You don't want it to go from white, gray to black. You want it to graduate throughout the image, and that really makes an image stand out. So that's what we want to capture in this image. We want to be able to create everything as it is. And a lot of artists will tell you, hey, this is how I saw it. This is how I want it captured. I don't want the color to be different. I don't want anything else to be different, which can be quite hard for photographers, because every camera, lens, lighting setup can change the colors, can change everything. So here we go. We're going to take a photograph of this, and we're going to see how we've done. All right, so get nice and close, frame it all up, make sure we're at 5.6, nice and sharp, at least 1/25th and above in terms of your shutter speed, and there we go. Beautiful.
All right, we'll take that back to the artist. We'll see how they like it. Hope they like it. If not, it's back to the drawing board, but I've worked with this artist quite a bit, so I think I've got this down pat. So never give up, guys. Make sure that you keep trying to figure out ways that you can capture that image. It might get frustrating, you know, throughout the process, and you might be upsetting the artist as you're going along, but make sure that they understand that you're working together as a team. You're collaborating on a project that's going to create stunning image results for them to edit and for them to send off to the printers and send off to the client. So I'll come and show you what this artist has done with this portrait and the photograph that we've captured for her. So, you know, we've done a few different, but you can see even between those two different images, the different colors in light, the different colors actually, blue to a bit of warmer color and the brightness. So that's what we're going to work with. Awesome, guys. Thank you for joining me. And remember, as always, keep on shooting.